I mean, this is pretty much all we're looking at. And I'll get into what I'm doing here in a minute. It's something that people have been asking me to do for a while. I mean, you can see it in the title. People have been asking me to do this for a while. Hey, Brett Favre got in the Hall of Fame. I didn't see any of this stuff a while ago. Okay, well, I mean, I guess I can show you guys what's going on here. And we have some we can set up some custom conferences before we get into this. But what I want to do is have a brand new Oklahoma Dynasty, because I've just been wanting to do that for a while. But I kind of want to mix up the conferences a little bit. And I know in the Big 12 I want to add Houston. That is definitely one person or one team that I want to add into the Big 12. And then I don't really know who else. Who did we have in my old Oklahoma Dynasty? I think we had a BYU, right? Because I think that's someone that we had. So we'll go ahead and add Houston back. Because I think Houston needs to be in there in real life. Add one more team. Don't know who we should add, though. I'm still kind of hoping y'all can hear me. Got no feedback so far. Who else can we add here? No one from the Pac-12. I want to bring in someone from a smaller conference. So let's go like American. Anyone want to join? I mean, we could add SMU, but they're kind of trash. I want to say it was BYU that I threw in before, right? And they're an independent, I think. Yeah. We'll go ahead and add BYU back in. Do we need to move anything around here, I think? Probably should have settled this up before I started streaming, but, you know, whatever. So we can just have the South all Texas teams. I think that'll be fine. So we'll swap those, and then we should be good. Texas. Nope. What am I missing here? Someone's got to get booted from the Big 12, I think. Unless I'm looking at this wrong. I didn't miss any Texas teams over here, did I? Let's switch these two. Let's put Oklahoma in the South. So Oklahoma is going to be the only team that's not in Texas in the Big 12 South. Now set up some conference rules. Hey, Shrey's here. Awesome. We'll go best conference record host. Division 1 name, we'll go, it'll be the Big 12 North. And if you guys comment something and I don't get to it, like, immediately, there is a delay. There's like a 15-second delay in between you typing, you guys can type and I'll see it immediately, but before you guys hear me, like, acknowledge it, there's a 15-second delay, if that makes sense. So yeah, Big 12 North, Big 12 South, let's go ahead and let's turn on Protected Rivals, because we're going to need... this one. We need to edit that. We need to make sure that we play Oklahoma State each year. What the heck? Okay, so I need to edit this one then. We need to make sure that we play Oklahoma State each year. Why can't I edit this? Sure, set that for there right now. Let me edit this one. There we go. Alright, so set that to Oklahoma. So every season we will play Oklahoma State. I think that's really the only one we need to guarantee to set up, unless TCU's got one that they need to play every year, but I don't think so. I think this will be fine. Just make sure that we play Oklahoma State every year, and then the rest of these don't really matter. At least I don't think. Protective Rivals, night games in November, that'll be fine. Conference games start week 2. Let's start those week 3. Get a couple weeks into the season before we play those. Where did I have the Big 12 championship in the older dynasty? Because I don't remember. I think I just had it in the Cotton Bowl, right? You guys remember it all? Because, I mean, we could just throw it in the AT&T Cotton Bowl. I mean, I think that's, or you know what we'll do? I know what we'll do. I think this might've been what I did during the older dynasty. OU Texas. There we go. We'll just throw it there. That should be fine. Neutral site, kind of. Back out of that. I don't think there's any other conferences we really need to mess with at all. Because I really don't care about the other conferences, honestly. We can go over what rules and difficulty I have it on, in case you guys want to see that. do the championship game in Kansas City. What is in Kansas City? Can I set it to a specific city? I mean, I can look up top and see what's there. There's gotta be one in Kansas City, right? Some sort of, what bowl game is in Kansas City? If there's a bowl game in Kansas City, that'll help me out tremendously. We could do the arm, throw it in Fort Worth. That's Charlotte, Birmingham, Orlando, Atlanta, Glendale, San Francisco, Jacksonville. How about we put it in Hawaii? That makes sense. Big 12 championship in Hawaii. Shreveport, Detroit, Washington, Nashville. They don't see one in Kansas City. That's the problem. So I think for right now, we're just going to, we'll go ahead and put it in OU, Texas. That's a neutral site game, Dallas, Texas. We'll be fine to put it there. It'll be all right. But now for the settings. What do I have it on? I even forgot. Heisman difficulty, we need to change that to Heisman, even though that doesn't matter here. Injuries on, fatigue on, quarter length, we'll change that to 8 minutes. Player minimum speed threshold will boost up to 50, because that was at 35 near the end of the Oklahoma Dynasty, and players like Casey Fountain, who had like 99 speed, were just demolishing people, and it was kind of unrealistic. These seem to be normal. I think if I mess with this, that'll stop the opposing quarterback from running so much. But the problem is, whenever they actually run, they're stupid. They don't slide at all. And then, well, I think I had this. I messed with these a little bit during the Oklahoma Dynasty. Bumped that up to 15 and 10. These are just the sliders that I used. And CPU, I think that was a massive problem in the Oklahoma Dynasty, is that no matter who I faced, it was, like, ridiculous. Okay. Why Hawaii, honestly? Why do it in Hawaii? I don't see a reason. That's like really random. So we'll just keep it in Dallas for right now. Oh, the BCS bowl tie-ins, do I still have them on? No, I took them all out before I started recording. Because I don't like the BCS system. And whenever you take it out like this, that just means you can pretty much go to any bowl game. So there's that. But let's go ahead and begin the Dynasty. And I think Just like last time, we're just going to take over as Bob Stoops. I don't want to fire Bob Stoops for no reason. Well, mainly, I don't want to get rid of Stoops, because if you start with a new coach, recruiting is such a pain. And I don't want to have like 2 or 3 down years, because I don't know how many seasons I'm going to do in this. But this Dynasty will only be streamed. It will be uploaded to YouTube in a few days, maybe. But for right now, like, this is the way you watch it. If you want to see it, like, immediately, is you just come here, and then in a few days I'll upload the entire stream to YouTube. Not gonna edit these though, but just go ahead and become head coach. So we'll be Bob Stoops, and have to start all over. Obviously, we'll have the 2013 schedule. I think there is a way to like mod the game and get the new schedule, but there's really no reason for it. We'll edit the schedule to the best of our ability. Holy crap. Bob Stoops did not have all this the first time I took over. We are already going to be able to recruit, like, superstars. I think last time I started, like, he had some of these. Like, these are recruiting traits, and they help you recruit players. And he has all but one. Okay? And he has all but one of the game management traits, too. Maybe starting as Bob Stoops is a little bit overpowered, but I'm just doing this for fun. Let's see what else we can do. Now we can set up recruiting board. That'll be fun. We get to see some of the top recruits and see who is available. But we'll check out the depth chart first and see. Obviously, starting quarterback for this season is going to be Baker Mayfield. This is last season's rosters, I believe. So, like, this is the 2015-2016 rosters. So we still have Trevor Knight. The updated rosters actually should be coming out in a couple months. So I might start a new dynasty then as well. I don't know. Like I said, I don't know how long this is going to go. But we do have Trevor Knight and Cody Thomas. Baker's still going to be the starter. Halfback Samaje Perine. And Mixon's not really rated that well. 83 overall. I think he could probably be a little bit higher. But I might be slightly biased. Why is Dimitri Flowers our fullback? Let's just auto-reorder this. And now Mark Andrews is our... No, Dimitri Flowers needs to be our fullback. He's already starting another position. Wait, is he starting at tight end? What the heck is going on with these rosters? Okay. We have a little bit of stuff to change real quick. Because why is Dimitri Flowers listed as tight end and Andrews is still listed at receiver? So whoever did this never fixed the... Or I guess he never realized. Can you do a coaching carousel with Bob Stoops? What exactly? Okay, so someone commented that the other day. What is a coaching carousel? Like, I know that at the end of the season, you have the coaching carousel. Like, how do you do that? Oh, why not starting Trevor? Because Baker Mayfield's a 94 overall. So, not really a competition there. Let me go in and change Dimitri Flowers and Mark Andrews to their actual positions. But anyway, here, I'll show you why I'm not going to start Trevor. Baker's a 94 overall. Trevor's an 82. They have the same speed. All right, Trevor's a little bit faster on acceleration. But where's the stat that I'm actually interested in? One, Trevor apparently has terrible carrying. Throw power, that goes to Baker. Accuracy goes to Baker. So we're gonna start Baker at 94 overall rather than 83 overall or 82 overall Trevor Knight. We'll also recruit some QBs. I don't really know. I mean, Trevor might transfer at the end of the season like he did in real life, but running back Samaje and Rodney Anderson's down here still. He might get redshirted, but we'll get to that here in a minute. Fullback. We don't have a fullback on the roster, but we have 500 receivers. One, you need to be changed to tight end. Notre Dame beat UNC. What? In basketball? I don't follow college basketball. I mean, I can pull that up to make sure that's what you're talking about. But where can I not change his position here? I have to wait till next offseason to do that. Okay. Alright. That makes no sense, but we'll just mess with the depth chart and fix that. We don't have a fullback on the roster, which is weird to me. I'm really hoping that you meant like Notre Dame beat UNC in basketball. But like I said, I don't follow college basketball, so. Just double checking. But let's go into the depth chart and mess with some of that stuff. Okay, in basketball it happened 80-76. Notre Dame greats upset in history. Well, Oklahoma got upset today too. Like I said, I don't follow college basketball, but I sure got that alert that number one Oklahoma fell to Kansas State 80-69. So let's go back to where are we at? Fullback. Okay, so first what we have to do is put this guy as our starting fullback, even though that's not what we're gonna do. And then head over here to tight end and make Andrews our starting tight end and Meyer our backup. Where is doesn't Trevor have a brother that plays tight end? He can be our third string. Is he on this roster? I could have swore Trevor had a brother on the team. Yeah, because he threw a touchdown pass to him earlier this year. Apparently Trevor makes a better tight end than some people. I guess his brother's not on the roster. Isn't he like our long snapper? Yeah, when the season's over, you get to click coach. Yeah, I know what you mean. Like, how do you make that into a series? Like, you want me to just go over and, like, accept a new job? With Bob Stoops? Stoops ain't leaving. If Stoops leaves, I'm gonna cry. If Stoops leaves Oklahoma, I'm gonna be done for a while. I mean, I'll still watch, but... So Flowers can take over Danley. I don't know why he's such a garbage fullback in this game. That makes no sense to me. Should we edit some of his ratings? But seriously, should we edit some of Flowers' ratings to make him a better fullback? A 56 overall, like, fullback right now. That's horrible. But look at the rest of the roster real quick. Left tackle, ooh, it's not good. Left guard, Okay, so our offensive line needs some work. Right guard is our best at 88 overall. That needs some work, definitely. Left end, Charles Taffer. Right end, Charles Walker. D-line needs a little bit of work, too. Outside linebacker, Dominique Alexander seems to be all right. Middle linebacker, I mean, I'm fine with that. He's a junior. Wait, what is... Oh, Alexander's a senior, so I'm going to need to recruit some left outside linebackers. Eric Stryker, 93 overall. And like I said, in case you didn't catch it earlier, these are last season's rosters. This is the 2015-2016 season's rosters. The new roster should be coming out within the next few months, and I might just restart a dynasty then. I don't know. But we still have Zach Sanchez, who is now a senior. Wait, why is he listed as a senior? That's real weird. Wasn't he a junior this year? Because he had to declare for the draft. Why will I be sad when Stoops retires at Oklahoma? Because he's coached Oklahoma my entire life. It'd just be weird to see him leave. Free safety, Atari Bird. Strong safety, Ahmad Thomas. It's like whenever Andy Reid left the Eagles, even after a 4-12 season. Like, Reid had been the coach of the Eagles the entire time I had been a fan of him, so it was really weird. Like, up until the Eagles hired Chip Kelly, none of my favorite teams had ever had to go through a coaching search while I've, like, been a fan. So that was a new experience for me. I think we're done looking at the depth chart for right now. Where do we want to go now? We want to go to recruiting or redshirt? No, let's go redshirt some players. Gotta redshirt some people. Let's head over here. And I don't know how long I'll be streaming. I think I'm going to stream until the Weave gets off work. How is the stream quality, guys? Yeah, you're playing as Bob Stoops or a coordinator because they're off your job at the end of the season. Where you go the first second week? Yeah, I'm not going to leave Oklahoma. Why am I a big Oklahoma fan? Because I was born and raised here. I was raised in Oklahoma. Fun fact, my mom is actually an Oklahoma State fan. But whenever growing up, my favorite color was red, so I chose the red team and just kind of stuck with them. We also can change our schedule, and we'll do that before we go to the recruiting board, but let's redshirt some players. Pretty much, I just redshirted a true freshman, but like I was saying and then got sidetracked, I'll probably stream for a couple hours until Weave gets off work, because we've got a couple things to record for you guys. Fun, like, side note, the Pokemon channel should be launching pretty soon. Stream quality is great, thank you, because I am super nervous about that, because my internet is normally garbage. So that's why I'm streaming in, like, very low quality compared to some people. But let's go ahead and redshirt Anderson, because he's a true freshman. I, like, buzzed through that. AD Miller is a true freshman? I'd redshirt him. And Dahu Green. I was actually very excited for Dahu Green this season because he's a big, tall receiver, and then he couldn't catch this year, at least. I think he got like 3 passes thrown to him and dropped 2 of them, 1 in the end zone. I was not happy. Left tackle, yeah, true freshman, you're getting redshirted. That's just my rule. Unless you're like the best at your position as a true freshman, you're... Oh, and then this situation where I'll normally just redshirt the best one. And if, like, a situation comes up, I will be able to, like, put him in. And it'll burn the red shirt, but I won't have to, like, play someone else at right tackle. See? This is, like, you're saying your internet sucks, Trey. But, like, my internet, we have a very small company called Vive. And they, like, switching to AT&T would be a dream. Yeah, really. Yeah, I was upset about the Dahu Green drop passes too, because it was just so frustrating, because I wanted to see like a tall receiver in our offense. That's why whenever we got what was his name? He went to the draft, Green Beckham, Dorial Green Beckham. I was so excited to get him because I was like, holy crap, we finally got like a tall, strong, fast receiver. And then he had to sit out that year, and then he left. I mean, he did okay in Tennessee this year, I think. Do we want to? No, we're not going to redshirt him, Vanasaur. Free safety, go ahead and redshirt him. Strong safety, redshirt Sunderland. Kicker? Whoa, Hodgson. Okay, so Cyber just listed as a punter. You can't list people as kicker and punter in this game. So, Seibert's just listed as a punter. Should we make him our starting kicker so it's like more realistic? And then we'll set our custom schedule. We could set our schedule to the upcoming schedule and see how well that works. Oh, wait, do I really want to... I don't know if I want to schedule Ohio State. I don't know if that is a grand idea. Also, how does my mic sound? Like, I know stream quality is good, but I wonder how my mic sounds compared to everything. Like, if my mic needs to be turned up or the game audio needs to be turned down, let me know. But let's go into the custom schedules now and switch that around a little bit. Or maybe we just make it a completely random schedule. Like, first team I see in the chat will be our first game. I'm not doing that because you guys will say, like, Alabama, and they're good. ULM? No. We're going to play... I want a ranked opponent. You know what? Let's do Clemson. Let's play Clemson and Norman. Why? Because we can. Who are we playing week one next season? Is it Houston? Is it Houston that we play in week one next year? Or is it... Because I think we play ULM next year as well. And I can't really remember. Because I know we have Houston, I know we have Ohio State, and I know we have ULM. Or Louisiana Tech. I get the two confused. Next season, we have Houston in our first game, then ULM, and then Ohio State. So, we put Houston in our conference. So, we can't play them week one. So, we're going to sub Houston for Clemson. Just because I want to try to get some revenge on Clemson. Week three, no, we're going to take out Tulsa. We don't want Tulsa. We want... Who do we want? I think Michigan was one of the few teams to beat us in our Oklahoma Dynasty. Should we go back and try to play them? No, you know what? Let's go for Ohio State. Let's make it somewhat real. And then maybe a beat-up team, not an FCS team. Those games just aren't fun. I guess we can add ULM in. So we'll have one beat-up team. Oh, God, we still have Notre Dame on the schedule. Nope, I'm not going to have Clemson, Ohio State, and Notre Dame. We can add a small school. Oh, you want Tulsa? Actually, instead of ULM, let's do Tulsa. Are they there? Or do they have a game already? Tulsa's not available for week four. Are they available for week one? Because we can move. We can maybe move Clemson. We can maybe move them. Okay, so we can get Tulsa week one. So I have a beat-up game, then Ohio State. Can we put Clemson here? No, but we can get Georgia, Florida State. I want some ranked opponents early so we can climb in the rankings fast. Because right now, what are we, like 19? Yeah, we're 19. So I want to get some ranked opponents early. Let's make this an open week so we don't play a game here. We'll play one week two. Who can we get here? Can we get Clemson here? Yes, we can. Okay. Whoa, at Clemson. Okay, we'll keep it. How many home games do we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Just making sure that we have, you know, 6 and 6. So I think that's going to be good. We have Tulsa, then Clemson, then Ohio State, then an open game, then Notre Dame, then TCU. So we're playing, we like stacked our schedule very early. I got an idea. Let's change this to open. And I'm trying to think, can we, because I don't want two open weeks in a row. That would be a good idea. So who's available down here at 10? I want someone that's going to be okay, yeah, we can just move Notre Dame down to here. And then we'll change this one to open. Yeah, I'm screwing with this a whole lot. East Carolina said Notre Dame. I can keep Notre Dame and maybe get East Carolina. They're not there, of course. I don't want to get too many unranked teams because then we get the situation where like I went undefeated but didn't go to the championship. Ooh, oh, nope, that's who we're adding. We're adding Nebraska. We're going to go to Nebraska week 4. Okay, I think that's going to be our schedule. Tulsa, Clemson, bye week, Nebraska, bye week. TCU, Texas, Kansas, Texas Tech, Notre Dame, Baylor, Oklahoma State, Kansas State, and then Houston. Don't know why we don't close the season against Oklahoma State. I thought that's the way the game would set it, but whatever. I think that'll work. I think that'll be fine. Because I want to get some revenge on Clemson for real life. We can, you know, bring back the Nebraska rivalry that's coming back in a few years anyway. And then we got TCU, then Texas, Kansas, Texas Tech. Then we got a ranked opponent late in the season at, you know, the ranked opponent. Make sure we have the right amount of away games. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so we have 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we can't change any of these. So should we make that a home game? Or should we make Nebraska a home game? Well, we've got to change one thing on the schedule. So should Nebraska be a home game or Notre Dame? I'll let you go. I'll let someone answer that one for me. Nebraska or Notre Dame? As I take a drink of water. Yeah. This is actually kind of fun. I'm just kind of scared because if I say something stupid, then it's there's no editing it out. I mean, I can whenever it goes to YouTube, but that's about it. Make Notre Dame the home game. Okay, that's what I'm doing. Yeah, that makes the most sense because we'd have oh my god, yeah, that's definitely the smarter choice. Or else we'd have like 4 road games in the last 5 weeks of the season. So I think we're gonna keep that. Would you like to keep changes to the schedule? Yes. Also, I said earlier we might be streaming for a couple hours. I don't know how many games we're gonna play. I think we can get 1 game in, and then I'll have to wrap up this stream. I don't really know how often I'm gonna be able to stream. So there's that as well. So let's go ahead and set up the recruiting board now. We're not going to create any prospects. If you want, you can go in and create like superstar prospects. But, you know, we're not going to do that. I thought about doing it one season in the Oklahoma Dynasty and not making them too OP. I would have probably made them like the same stats as Road to Glory guys, but decided against it just because it gets to be too much. Like, you get people mad because they're not realistic. Let's go ahead and search some of these top recruits. What do we need? Should I write that down? I feel like I should write down what we need. Just to, you know, make sure that I actually get them. Sure, yeah, go ahead and say that. I have, like, random notepads open on my desktop. But anyway, we need 2 middle linebackers. We need a kicker. No, we don't need a kicker. We need a punter. I guess it doesn't really matter. Outside linebacker, center. And what else? A fullback. And we're also going to get a quarterback because Baker's a junior, Knight's a junior, Cody Thomas is a junior. I don't even know if you have any other quarterbacks on the roster. What slider set am I using? I am using it's Charter 04's Heisman sliders with a little bit of tweaks. I'll show them again before I jump into the first game. Let's go ahead and just search by all positions so we can see everything. And I always do this. I will instantly go over here and see who is the fat. Oh my god, the top three people want to come to Oklahoma. Well, welcome to the board, because if you want to play for us, we are fine with that. That guy's name is Michael Jackson. Okay. That's a little bit weird, but best 40 time. A corner. There's a receiver. See, these receivers are kind of trash normally, like especially whenever they're ranked 342. And a 3-star, but I think Casey Fountain was a 3-star receiver, that 99 speed receiver I had in the last season of Oklahoma Dynasty. We'll go ahead and add him too, Andrew Clay. All right, so now let's scout some QBs. Who is the best quarterback in the country? Scott Brown. He's got a decent 40 time. Pierre Norwood he's a pocket passer. Any decent like fast QBs that want to join us? Oh my god, not a whole lot. Normally the fast quarterbacks are athletes. Like Corey Cannon and Mark Bailey were both athletes. And they were both pretty fast. So I normally don't add... Wait, B. Bell. Oh, kind of hoping that guy's name would be Blake Bell. In case you're wondering, these are not real people. These are auto-generated names. There's that guy. He doesn't... 4-star, 4.42, 40. Speed back. I'm fine with that. 5'9", 168. That's another Allen Melton type of running back. And I won't fill the entire recruiting board right here. I'll let the CPU do some of it. Get fast QB. Yeah, I know. I know you like mobile quarterbacks. I'll go look for them. Receivers, Nick Garner, 6'1", decent 40 time, 5-star athlete. Yeah. We'll add this guy too. Greg Langford, 6'2", 208, 4'3", 40, 5-star recruit. Carl Bennett, 5'11", 180. That's like a Sterling Shepard type. Like, he's not incredibly tall, but he's fast. And who's the fast receiver here? Scott Harris. We'll go ahead and throw him on the recruiting board just to see what we can get. Kevin Rhodes, 4'3", 4", 6'3", 206. Okay, there's our big receiver that we want to get. What were all the positions that we needed now? Middle linebacker is the first one that shows up. Yeah, we definitely... Who is our middle linebacker? Is it Stryker? No, Stryker's right outside linebacker. Yeah, let's sort this by rank. Anthony Hyde, the number one middle linebacker, always added the top guy. We got a few good people right here that want to join us, so we'll add all four of these guys to the board. Filled up half the board already, and we're gonna get one of these five. Whenever I use like a powerhouse school like Oklahoma, I will always try to pull in the top recruits, because other than that, what's the point? I feel like we do need to pick up a couple outside linebackers, because we're losing Eric Stryker and potentially our left outside linebacker. I forget his name right now, but we could potentially lose him. I know we're losing Sanchez at the end of the season because for some reason he is listed as a senior. Dallas Kirk, the number one corner, we'll add him too. Thomas Hefner, 4'4", 40, 4-star. We'll go ahead and add him. I'm forgetting about the other positions that we need. Oh, we do have outside linebacker on the list. Okay, I was just forgetting about that. We need a kicker, center, and a fullback. Fullback definitely, because we have no fullbacks on the roster. Look at that, the number one kicker wants to join us. We're first interest of his. Okay. I'm fine with that. Punter, was that something? No. Sure, I was thinking punter was on the list. I was like, no, our punter is listed as a freshman. We need a punter for a while. And none of the top centers are interested in us. What's the highest rated center that's interested? No centers are interested in coming to Oklahoma. That's not good. Who's the strongest guy that's decently ranked? You, Steven Jordan. I will make you want to become a Sooner. And anyone else that we could add? Just like kind of go down the list here. Add him. He's got a good bench press. 450. That's good. I think that's it, right? Oh, fullback. And then we'll let the CPU add the other ones. Yeah, just go ahead and throw the top two fullbacks up there. We'll actually look at a couple more athletes. How many do we have? Oh my god, there's a few interested here. Another 5-star athlete. Welcome to our recruiting board. You have a first interest in us, but you can definitely come on board. You're fast, so welcome on. Okay, so we'll leave 6 spots for the CPU to add in someone. No need for a fullback? Yeah, but if I don't get it, then, like, if I don't have at least one fullback on the roster after the next offseason, the game will automatically give me one. And I've been streaming for 45 minutes, and we haven't even played a game yet. That's great. But right now, we can scout some of these guys. So let's go scout these athletes. Is there a quarterback among these? Oh, this guy. 89 speed, 86 throw power, and 80 accuracy. Andre Cross. What about Ryan Hall? Can you throw the ball? He can't throw the ball, but he can definitely run. 90 speed, 92 acceleration. What is he? Receiver, looks like a little decent receiver, like mediocre running back maybe, because he can't hit, he can catch, he can route run definitely, but he's not breaking tackles. So yeah, I'm thinking he's like, he could be a solid receiver or a very bad running back. Also, we have Michael Jackson here. What is he good at? 87 speed, 90 acceleration, 87 throw power, 82 accuracy. Michael Jackson might be our next quarterback. Kind of weird to say, but Michael Jackson could be a decent QB. Andrew Clay, 95 speed, 88 acceleration, can't throw the ball. What is he good at here? How do you have 84 spectacular catch but 67 regular catching? What are you good at? Okay, this guy, he looks to be more of a running back. Dan Daniels. He can't throw the ball either. Doesn't have good speed. He looks to be like a safety? Maybe? 72 zone, 71 man. Can't catch. Maybe like a linebacker? I don't know. Serge Jennings. He can throw the ball. 93 speed, 89 acceleration, 85 throw power, 82 accuracy. Use Ryan Hall as a receiver. Ryan Hall. Yeah, that's what I was thinking. It's like he's either going to be a decent receiver or a very mediocre running back. And then Darius White. 92. He's a gem. 92 speed. So we have a few quarterbacks on this list, actually. So we got a few guys that we could recruit. Obviously, none of these guys would be on the roster until next season if we get them. But who was it? Serge Jennings? That was good. Yeah, 93 speed, 89 acceleration. So if we get him, he can either be a very good corner or a very good quarterback. That would be fun to have that. And then Michael Jackson could either be a QB or it looks like a receiver. Oh, what about Darius White with 92 speed? I'm looking at Serge again. Does he have the best accuracy out of all the potential quarterbacks? No, but he does definitely have the best speed at 93. That would be fun with read options. And then him. Okay, so I need to move on because we need to at least play one game in our first stream, right? Let's look at halfback. Chris Vaughn, 90 speed. So we'd have a quarterback faster than our running back. That wouldn't be a good idea. And 93 speed, 92 acceleration. He dropped 4 in overall. That's almost a bust. I don't really know if you're any good, dude. Do we really... Yeah, let's go ahead and look at some of these receivers. Or we'll look at all of them. We have enough... Yeah, we have enough points. Speed, 84. That's not going to fly on my offense. Who's a better runner, Baker or Trevor? Baker. Trevor seems to have more speed, but Baker is smarter. 92 speed, 90 acceleration, 72 catching. Carl Bennett, you're not that fast. Oh, never mind, 93. Okay, that was higher than we thought. 76 catching, 70 spectacular catch, 82 route running. Scott Harris. Oh, yeah, that was the dude who could just run, but his acceleration is apparently bad now. Kevin Rhodes, once again, another one that can run. He's got decent acceleration, actually. We'll have to come back and look at these guys at the end of the season. Middle linebackers, let's look at Anthony High, because that was one. Okay. Any of you guys like a gem? Okay, Eric Goods, 81 overall. He's got amazing acceleration. Brian Hammond, what do you got? Okay. Kevin Walters. And Lonnie Moore. So the best one's Eric Good, overall wise. He's got decent tackling, okay hit power. I want another Charles Rice. That guy was fun to use. That dude could, like, lay people out. And then we have 50 points left, so let's just go ahead and throw it at a corner. Okay, he's got A speed, A acceleration, B man, B zone. Dallas Kirk might need to become an Oklahoma Sooner, like, as soon as possible. That's amazing. Especially because we're losing Sanchez. But I think it's all we can do with recruiting. Eric Good will work. Yeah, Eric Good seems to be very good, actually. Hopefully we can get him. I don't remember where he was on our... I don't remember where we were on his interest, though. I think we seem to be good. We redshirt people. We've set our depth chart. We have custom schedules. We set up our recruiting board. I think we can go ahead and start the season. So let's go ahead and advance to the regular season. I've been live streaming for an hour now, and we are just now advancing to the regular season. Awesome. And I'm going to go ahead and take another drink of water, because I've been straight just talking for over an hour. Okay. kind of getting nervous going to our first game. What time is it? It's currently 9 o'clock, in case you're wondering. I mean, most of you guys probably live in Oklahoma, so you're on the same time zone as me. This is one thing about this game, is it takes forever to advance weeks. Like, whenever I'm editing Riker Sterling, it's just like this, like, three-minute gap of silence that I have to cut out. Speaking of, I need to record more Riker Sterling. I haven't started recording season 2 yet, or sophomore season. I need to record that. Should probably record some more Corey Cannon. I think I said this earlier, but the Pokemon channel should be launching soon. I am, like, currently recording either a good chunk or all of Pokemon Yellow, because I'm redoing that. And I'm, like, halfway through the game. So it could start. My goal is to have it start by, like, February 27th, which is, like, the 20th anniversary of Pokemon. But it could launch before then. I'll put it on Twitter whenever I decide to launch it. In case you're wondering about that. I need to go to the slider set so that one dude can see sliders. But we'll go ahead and set up some recruiting. We can still do that. And the CPU did add a few people, but I don't think anyone we're really going to go after. Okay, so we are fifth on Eric Good's list. We're just going to throw everything at him right now because that is our, like, number one recruit right now. So throw a scholarship at him and max scout him. Like, you have a certain amount of points you can use. I'm just using 700 points every week towards him. I think it was the athletes, right? Yeah, Serge Jennings. Okay, this guy, he was the one with 93 speed, right? Yes, 93 speed, 89 acceleration, 85 throw power, 82 accuracy, and we are top on his list. That's insane. I miss playing this game. My controllers are screwed up. Oh, man, that sucks. Do you still have the cord? If you still have the USB cord, you can still do it. If not, they're pretty cheap right now because the PS4's out. Serge Jennings, yeah, just go throw everything at that kid. We need him. That kid's going to be a Sooner, I guarantee it. Any of these other athletes that want to become Sooners? Like, this guy's close to becoming a Sooner. We'll go ahead and scout some of these guys, and I think the CPU will divide up the rest of these points that I don't use. I can't talk right now. But, yeah, we'll go ahead and throw in it right now. He's 6'5". This was the receiver, right? 90 speed, 92 acceleration with some catching. Right? Yeah, 77 catching. He is 6'5". That's insane. Yeah, we want him. Darius, where's Michael Jackson? How tall is he? 6'2"? Then we have Darius White. What was he good at? He could throw the ball. He's got 92 speed, 88 acceleration. He could play receiver. Maybe. This would be we'll throw some points in him. We're not going to use all of our scouting points here because I want the CPU to have some control. Because that's what I did in the Oklahoma Dynasty. I got the players I wanted, and that was it. Man, that sucks about your controller. I've had this same controller since I got the PS3, and that was right before my junior year. So that would have been, dear God, like 5 years ago? 6 years ago? It's been a while. This one still works. I have another one that a family member gave me, but it's completely broken. Like, whenever I try to use it, instead of vibrating, it clicks. And it's super annoying to use. Yeah, it sucks about your controller. I don't think they're too expensive right now. Have you tried using, like, other people's controllers? And see if they connect to it, or if it's just your PS4 or PS3. Do we have any tall receivers here? Because if not, we're not going to spend too much time doing this. We'll go ahead and throw some points into this guy, 6'4". But I think the rest of this, because that was really like the two that I really wanted, was that athlete, or those couple of athletes, and the middle linebacker. I was about to, I think we're going to let the CPU do the rest of this. The CPU tends to be pretty good about it. And it'll most of the time keep the things that I chose. It's happened with 3-0? Oh man, that's weird. That might be your PS3, dude. Honestly, I don't know how this stuff works, but we'll check sliders one more time just so you guys can see that. Dynasty House rules. With this, it's just the normal, like, I just let this default because it worked well for me in the old Oklahoma Dynasty. And then 8 minute quarters, 50 players threshold. I think I actually, like, I feel like I should lower this. We'll put that in the middle because I had it at, like, we'll put it at 40 because I had it at 35 for the Oklahoma Dynasty and it was okay. And 50 might be a little bit too much. So we'll put it at 40. If we need to change stuff, we will. Custom AI for the user. These are sliders that I'm using. It's Charter 04 sliders with some variations. Just to, you know, make it a little bit more realistic. The QB accuracy was one that I definitely lowered because in the Oklahoma Dynasty, it was just super weird. Because, like, a backup quarterback would come in and just be Tom Brady. I mean, not Tom Brady in college, it'd be like NFL Tom Brady. But then here are the rest of the sliders that you can see. And I think that's it. So we're ready to jump into our first game. And it probably will be the only game from this stream, at least. And like I said, I don't know how often I'm going to be able to stream. And I'll try not to have it cut into recording time too much. But I think we're ready to jump into week one and hopefully not get demolished by Tulsa. Hopefully it doesn't end up like the Riker-Sterling series. But let's go ahead and advance in. Offense, ECU, defense 3-3-5. No, we're not going to use ECU's offense. What the heck? I apparently need to go change this playbook. And I understand, you know, he used ECU's offense now, but that's not the playbook I'm familiar with. Playbook I'm familiar with is Oklahoma's. There we go. And 4-3. We'll make sure that that's there every time we play. Well, let's go in advance of the game. Yeah, that does suck about your controllers, man. I love this game. This game's been out for, what will it be this year, like 3 years? And I'm still playing it, still having a lot of fun with it. Still have a series with it on my channel. It's the first game I decided to stream on my channel. Sorry, I was moving around in my chair a little bit. I'm trying to get comfortable. Because this game's about to take an hour. Hopefully they don't give us too much of a problem. Man, this team isn't that good. Hopefully Karis Garrett doesn't give us as much problem as he did in real life. But let's go ahead and advance in. And let me know once we get into the game, like, if the game audio is too loud right now. Because if it is, I can change some stuff. What's my real name? Why? That really necessary, honestly? I'll tell you, it's not Knight. It's not my real name. And let's go ahead and advance past all the highlights. So, nope, get out of here. Don't need any of that. Yeah, I don't really know why I need my real name, dude. Honestly, kind of weird. Don't need you guys, like, trying to find me on Facebook and stuff. Which, there is not a Teenage Knight or the Nightwing Facebook at all. But can we just advance past all this stuff, please? All right, there we go. Get to the coin toss. And we're going to kick first. And kickoff. Okay. Let's get ready to start this brand new series. And we are off. Okay. So, and this is going to be a touchback, first thing. Let's hope I'm not as bad at defense anymore as I used to be. Oh, you want to know why? So, just call me Knight. It's like in the name. Just say Knight. And their coach is coaching his first game at Tulsa. Did they update their... I wonder if they updated the coach's name. But... do we want... Yeah, you know what we are going to do. We're going to control Charles Tapper. Because I love controlling the end in this game because it's super funny. Okay, what the heck? That was a very quick pass. But let's try not to do that again. That kind of scared me. I thought they were, like, going to catch me off guard and get a huge gain there. Second and 10. See if we can get anything. Tapper comes through. Yep, see, that's why it's so much fun to use the right end or left end in this game. You can just bowl over their tackle like he's nothing. And, you know, I'm just having fun in this. This isn't really for realism. This one's just mainly for fun. You know, no, let's run an all-out blitz. I feel like this is a horrible idea, but we're going to do it anyway. And coming at him. Come on, make it. Yes, intercepted, Jordan Thomas. Or Ahmad Thomas. I thought it was Jordan. That was Ahmad Thomas. Okay, and who in the world is Green? Because that's what Blitz was. I have no idea who Green is. But Ahmad Thomas gets our first pick of this series, so that's fun. Do we want to come out and just heave it? Like, first play, just heave it to the end zone? Don't want to run a Hail Mary. Let's run a play action. Let's just chunk it, see what happens. Did you start a new dynasty? Yes, this is a brand new one. This is with an updated roster. I did actually consider just going on to season 7. I'm just going to take off. Oh my god, Baker got leveled. But I did consider starting a season 7 with the other Oklahoma Dynasty, but... I mean, I could still do that in the future, but I just kind of wanted to use Baker. I didn't get to use Baker too much in my other one, so wanted to use him. And what? Okay. They're for half a second. I thought that said number 9. I thought Trevor Knight had already come in the game. I was like, great, I got Baker injured on my first play. And heave that down the sideline. Make the catch. Okay, that probably should have been picked up. Will Barrow. Is that poor kid's real name? Like Wheelbarrow? Will Barrow? Anyway, 3rd and 5. And that seriously looks like number 9, not number 6. Okay, well, we'll take the snap and just go to the outside. Caught by Jarvis Baxter. Got the first down. I don't even think I got to use Baxter in the other one, right? No, because he wouldn't have been on the team. I also didn't get to use D.D. Westbrook. So it'll be fun to use those guys. And I think I just ran this place with an audible. I need to run it with Samaje. Oh, this is one of my favorite plays. Deron Neal is in a receiver, so... See, hold on. I want to check something. He is number 6, right? Because on my camera view, he looks like 9. Yeah, that's just really, really close. Okay, I guess. But in shotgun, P Ryan in the backfield. Take the snap. And come on, get open over the middle, Didi. Or Deron, I don't even know who you are. We're just going to take off. Screw it. You got those guys. Never mind. Gain of 9. Please don't get injured. Alright. 2 carries, 14 yards. I'll just run it with Samaje right up the middle. See if they're expecting this at all. How's the like game quality look in game? Because like moving around the menus might look a little bit different. And Samaje Perine powers his way into the end zone. Touchdown Sooners. Our first carry with Samaje Perine results in a touchdown. I think that shows that this is going to be pretty good. Hopefully our defense can continue playing the way they did last drive. And just boot that right down the middle. Okay, I moved it because of my habit from Madden. Because if you guys remember season 1 of that Browns franchise, I missed like 3 extra points. And Michigan State barely beat Western Michigan. That's surprising, but... If you guys remember season 1 of our Browns franchise, I missed so many extra points that I just got into the habit of always moving it in the direction of the wind. And I just did it there and almost resulted in a miss. But let's see if our defense come out strong still. Okay, so now... Well, and I'm also getting ESPN alerts as I'm playing. And I now see that Cam Newton won the NFL MVP. Not really a shock. Went 15-1. Probably deserved it out of everyone. Let's blitz. Let's use Stryker and let's blitz him. Come on, let me through. Alright, he is wide open. Whose guy is that? Alright, Thomas made the tackle. 11-yard gain. It's really weird not being able to hear any sound. I probably should have turned up my TV a little bit. Because, like, I can hear myself echo. It's weird. Okay. So we're going to bring Tapper again, because I like being in the end more than anything. Okay. Alright, that was some great... Holy crap, Atari Bird leveled it. And now they're running no huddle. See, that was another thing in this game, is that they ran a lot of no huddle. No matter who you were playing against. And, okay, that's a game of about 6. I'm still checking the comments every few seconds, in case you guys put something in there. Do we want to blitz? Yeah, you know, let's blitz the safeties. Let's play risky a little bit. Let's blitz this. Oh, I timed that perfectly. Coming through, Amata. Oh my god, Thomas. You gotta sack him whenever it comes down like that. He shoved him off like he was nothing. I mean, granted, it was still an incomplete pass, but Thomas, come on. You guys are going to see how mad I get now whenever someone drops an interception. Yeah, no huddle offense is good. It's just in this game, they run it all the freaking time. It's like everybody's coach is Chip Kelly. And there he goes, brought down the backfield, loss of 7. I feel like I got better at blitzing because of the Browns franchise. Because that first season, my secondary wasn't good, so I blitzed the QBs a lot. Yeah, like I was saying, I have no problem with no huddle. It's just, like, in this game, it's so much. Like, they put it in here way too much. And our punt returner is Joe Mixon. I guess that makes sense. Okay, yeah, Mixon is our punt returner in real life, so. But this time, we'll actually have to, holy crap, I thought we were going to block that. Nope, juke out that guy. Come on, get to the edge, Mixon. You can do it. Don't block in the back, anyone. Okay. 11-yard return, got to the 25. I mean, it's all right. Yeah, so in case you're wondering, the delay is about one play. Because on my preview screen, I can see them punting right now. So the delay is about one play. So first and 10, and where can we go with it? Okay, not really liking that nobody's getting open right now. So throw on the run right there, wide open D.D. Westbrook. Down to 45. Okay, I don't know if he was actually wide open. We still got a 30-yard gain. All right, man, if you got to go, that's no problem. Thanks for hanging out for a little bit. Oh, OU punt returner Shepard? I think Mixon did Mixon returned a few punts this year because I remember him in the backfield, especially at the game I went to. He, like, jumped around in a circle. It was weird. It was like he had some sort of ritual. And, oh my god, how did I get out of that? I thought Mayfield was about to get leveled. That could have been a much better read option, honestly. Yeah, with Shepard being our punt returner last season, that always scared me. I don't like having our number one receiver back there returning punts. Second and 5, and, okay. Really? Nobody's going to get open again? Oh my god, I thought Westbrook caught that. He reached out with one hand and almost pulled that in. Okay, I need to run the ball a little bit more. But it is third down. So we are going to throw here. And see what we can get. Here comes our tight end, Andrews. I think his first play he's in. On third and 5. And nobody's open again. Okay. And now Mayfield's stiff-arming people. And we're going to get brought down short of the marker. I tried to take off. I was holding R2. Yeah, mainly Shepard. When I was in Norman, I saw it was. Yeah, that's what I was saying. Is like, I agree with you on that. It was mainly Shepard, and I am going for it on this fourth down. It was mainly Shepard, but Mixon did return sometimes. Fourth and 3. There's a snap, roll out to the left side, and yeah, we're just going to take off. We're just going to get the first. And keep going, Baker. There you go, 14-yard gain. Alright, I'm running a little bit too much with Baker. I don't want him getting hurt. Oh, triple option. Yep, I'm ignoring that for right now because I love the triple option play. And where are they going to go? All right, they don't read Baker. And there we go. Pitch back to Samaje. Truck through that guy like he's nothing. Break up another tackle. And touchdown, Oklahoma. Samaje Perine has 2 carries for 2 touchdowns. I mean, we're doing pretty good so far. I feel like it's okay. And just go ahead and kick this one through the uprights and take a 14-0 lead. Okay, defense, what can you do for us now? Can you play as good as you have so far? That would be amazing. Oh, I never made the topics list for the podcast. I just realized that. I meant to do that before I started streaming. I mean, I don't even know if there's going to be a podcast yet, because me and Weave discussed that once he gets off work and gets home and we get on Skype. But normally I'll make it before, and then if we don't do it, then I just can it. Yeah, keep it up. I'm going to try. We're going to see what else we can do. Come on, Tapper. I need you to force that quarterback to fumble the ball at least once today. Okay, really? How are you not going to bring him down right there? There you go, Charles Walker. That's a gain of only 1. How do I say his name? Tavarion Dickerson? 3 carries, 19 yards. Okay, you want to call no huddle? We're going to blitz again. Last time I blitzed you, you threw a pick. This isn't a great call. Okay, he went. That was a stupid throw because one of those receivers was completely uncovered because Hatari Bird was supposed to cover him, and Hatari Bird was on the other side of the field. Who in the world is Green? It's not Dago Green, right? He's not out there playing cornerback, right? Get back there and get him, Tapper. Come on. Okay, go. Oh, what are you doing? Hatari Bird's going to get that every time. And go to the outside. Come on. Right down 35. This is an incredible first quarter. I may need to bump up QB accuracy a little bit for the CPU because he's making some dumb throws. But that Hatari Bird got the pick, so we'll continue on. And it's not like this is a... I mean, I think this is a good slider testing game. And now Samaje is going to come back out. And we're going to give it to him again. Can he go three carries for three touchdowns? No, he can't. Okay. 1 yard loss. He just doesn't have as good speed as I'm used to with running backs. I mean, I'm still going to obviously keep him as a starter because he's still great, but... let's run a read option. Let's see if we can get anything with that. And... Alright, so we're reading the end right there. And yep, give it to Samaje right up the middle. And keep powering through. Okay. 8 yard gain on the play. 4 carries, 38 yards, 2 touchdowns. He's having an okay first quarter. And remember, in this game, there is no playoff system anymore. I mean, there is no playoff system. It's still the BCS. I don't know why I said anymore. But roll out to the right side. And holy crap, who was that wide open in the end zone? Oh no, Baker. Baker, you had Shepard wide open. 4th and 3. Yeah, we're in field goal range. Just kick it. Where's the wind? Okay. So angle this a little bit to the left. So I don't get exactly what I want. Oh, my God. Thought the wind would keep that. Thought the wind would carry that a little bit more. Apparently not. All right, Hatari Bird. Get another pick. Come on. Make up for that horrible-looking offensive possession. 1st and 10. Evans in shotgun. Whatever that running back name is in the backfield. Tapper, come on. Get to him at least once. All right, down at the 50. 22-yard gain from Joshua Atkinson. Atkinson? Don't know exactly how you're supposed to say his name. Still can't believe I missed that stupid field goal. That would technically be Seibert's first kick of his career because this is last year's stats. And not last year's stats, but last year's rosters. 1st and 10. There we go. Get back to him. Okay, we hit him, but Dickerson was left wide open. Hatari Bird, please get there. Okay. 35-yard gain. Okay, defense. Not doing what I wanted to right now. We're going to play a little bit of zone. Everybody's going into zone. Because, yeah, we have two guys rushing the quarterback. They will not throw the ball here. Oh, so they run right up the gut on us. Crap. 7-yard gain. Now you guys can see how bad I am at this game. Because a play like that would not have gotten shown in the edited, like after editing, because it didn't result in a first down, and I don't think it was an important play. And yeah, no, you're going down. 7 yard loss. Please tell me Thomas was the one that got back there. I think, yeah, they are going to give me credit for the sack right there. Because look, I came up and then I hesitated and came around the edge. Because I saw that running back and I didn't know if he was going to try to make that throw. Okay, Sanchez. Can you cover your guy in green? I have no idea who green is. I'm going to have to look at the depth chart here in a second. Because that's bugging me. What happened on that throw? He threw it right into the dude's back. Like, I feel like that wasn't a grand idea there. All right, field goal block. And I'm just checking to make sure everything's still recording for me. And, yeah, please open that back up so I can continue. So I can see if the stream's still going. All right. So right down the middle. So it's 14-3. And we're just now about to get our first kickoff of the day. So I have to see how we do with that kind of field position. And back to return is going to be Mixon and Shepard. So I guess Mixon is going to be our main punt return. We may keep it like that, actually. And, all right, right out of the 20. We may keep it like that because I don't want to have our star receiver back there returning kicks and returning punts all the time. Let's flip sides on that so we can send Shepard deep. And this time, if Shepard gets open, please don't overthrow him, Baker. Oh, my God, that's 6. Except for Baker sails it. What in the world? That should have been a touchdown. Oh, turn down game volume? Let me know how that works. But Baker just sailed that. Ah. That's frustrating. Alright, well, come back out and try some other one. Alright. Oh my god, what? Okay. That got picked. That got intercepted. How? Like, no, we're looking at the replay on that. We're gonna look at the replay on that one. Because that's insane. All right, he tips it. I understand that. And then this dude comes in and scoops it up right before it hits the ground. Yep. Great play. Great play. Okay, let's try not to let them in one possession of the game. First and 10. See if we can hit this QB a few times. Please just get back. Tapper! I don't know why I can't get off the block. The run Neil sucked. That wasn't on Neil. That was the pass getting tipped. That DB made a decent play. No, we're not. I keep trying to blitz. Got to get out of blitzing mindset. I'm not playing Madden 16 right now. Second. Oh my God! Come on. Who is that? Thomas should have been paying attention and probably picked that off. I think he had a chance to. But no, that interception was not on Deron Neal. That pick was on the safety making a great play. Both of them. First one for tipping it away, and then this. Oh, Tapper got by his guy. No. All right. Yeah, you're not catching that. Fourth and 3. Who knocked it out of his hand? Was that Mbanasaur that made that play? All right. Yeah. Field goal block. Mixon. Come on. You can do it. I believe in you. I've never once blocked a field goal in this game. And that one is going to be good. So it's a one possession game. Sounds better. Okay. All right. As long as that sounds good. I did lower the game volume a little bit. If it sounds good to you guys. All right, Mixon. Juke out. There we go. All right, now. Then he breaks a tackle. And then we make that guy miss. Still breaking tackles and finally brought down to 30. Mixon is a monster. Okay, we've got to get something going on offense. We've had two positions in a row where we got nothing. We started off good and then just kind of fell apart. So we're going to run it with Samaje a little bit more and see if we can bust off a huge gain or something. Right at the middle. There we go. Truck through that safety. Oh my God, Samaje's still going through people and brought down after a decent gain across the 50-yard line. 5 carries for 60 yards. Samaje, the one in real life? The field goal block in real life? Yeah, I mean, that one's good. I've just never done it in, like, a video game. But Samaje might be really fun to use this year and might be the center point of our offense. Because in real life, we run that, like, air raid offense, and, you know, we do run the ball a little bit. But we might run a lot in this offense, especially if Samaje is going to do that every game. Because that'll be fun. And now on first and 10, as we start second quarter, handoff to Samaje. And, all right, he broke a couple tackles, but still got brought down for a loss of 1. I kind of want to run a play action and see if we can get someone deep here. But we'll just go with a deep ball. Come on, I hope that, please, one of you safeties screwed up. All right, looks like they're both ready to play the deep ball. So we're going to take this and get to the outside right there on the run. Caught by Pirine. And one guy's going to bring him down. Okay. Let's say if one dude brings him down, he'd be kind of angry. That's a gain of 14 on the play, though. And now, there's a play action. So we'll run that. 3 of 8 for 58 yards and a pick. I am not playing that well with Baker. Now in shotgun, take the snap. And force that over the... Okay, never mind. Incomplete. 3 of 9. I am not playing very well with a quarterback right now. Let's try that play. This play always seems to work in my Oklahoma Dynasty, or at least like, I was at 80% of the time. I think I ran this earlier today and it didn't work. But here we go over the middle, right there, Deron Neal inside the 10, and finally brought down at the 5, a 30-yard gain, first and goal. And now we're just gonna give it to Samaje and see if he can't get his third touchdown this half. 4 of 10. I gotta get better with Baker. I cannot play like that against, you know, the better teams. We still have some tough games coming up. And now on first and goal, under center. Hand off to Samaje to the outside. Come on, power through that tackle. There you go. Gain of 2. but it probably should have been about a loss of one. 7 carries for 61 yards. I mean, we're doing okay. Still doing all right. Oh, let's run a QB draw. Let's see if we can get Baker into the end zone. Because they'll probably be expecting to go to Samaje here. So on second and goal, QB draw right up the middle. And he is brought down at the 1. 2-yard gain. So now, we have the option. Do we just give it to Dimitri? Let Dimitri run it in? Or do we toss it? Yeah, we're going to toss it to the outside. We're going to see if Samaje can use his speed. And is that... Alright, yeah, it is Samaje in the backfield. So on third... Yeah, he's going to get in. Touchdown, Oklahoma. He has 3 touchdowns in the first half. I think he's having a pretty good day. He's got like 7 carries for like almost 70 yards now and 3 touchdowns. Obviously, I'm not throwing the ball too well, so I'm looking to improve that at some point today. But, you know, I'll take a 21-6 lead. Hi, KVON24. I don't know if I said your name right. KVON? I don't know. But hi. You said hi in the chat. Alright, 6 minutes to go in this half. So we'll just kick off Hodgson. And back to return. It's probably going to be another touchback, isn't it? Yep. That's exactly what we're doing. And I missed this because I was looking at the stream, but did that say Mississippi State was beating Oklahoma State? I just happened to look at the stream preview as that was happening. But first and 10. Ooh, in the bottom of the screen, you could see Oregon was beating someone. I didn't even see who it was, but they were winning. Or they won, I'm not really sure. But first and 10, let's see if we can get some sacks today. This is kind of ridiculous. And what the heck are you doing, Thomas? Why were you like 10 yards away from your guy? Karras Garrett for a 10-yard gain. Overstorm Brave, so let's go ahead and blitz with Jordan Evans. And, all right, they got the first. Okay, he's still breaking tackles. 6-yard gain. I mean, we're playing all right on defense. We haven't let up a touchdown yet, so I'm kind of considering that a success. Now, first and 10, Evans is going back into the backfield. 5.5 minutes going to half. And Tapper, come on, get back there. Holy crap, he's wide open. What? Level him. 27-yard gain. Okay, I got to stop blitzing. Light cushion defense. It's not really working too well. We're not doing too well with it. I'm just bringing Tapper. So if the other guys don't do their job... What the heck? Level him. Thank you. Loss of 1. But Sanchez would tackle... You know what? No, Sanchez does tackle like that in real life. He only goes for the big hit, though. Like, I really want Sanchez to do well at the NFL level. But I just don't know. Because, like, he breaks on the ball very well. He just doesn't wrap up. He just tries to level people. That's a problem. You gotta get him hurt in the NFL. But 5-yard gain to Tyler Wilson sets up 3rd and 6, and they're still gonna run no huddle. Yeah, we're not gonna blitz this time. We'll just keep bringing Tapper. But you know what? No, let's switch to Diamond. Let's see if we can get a sack of Matt Diamond. And holy crap, Hatari Bird! Bird! Why weren't you covering that guy? He was in your zone. We're about to let up a touchdown. I can feel it. Everybody blitz, please. Because we're going to need to hit him. And, wow. We leveled him, but he got into the end zone. Touchdown. That was some horrible defense on that drive. I mean, that's like 90% on me. But, I mean, that 1 3rd down, like, Hatari Bird wasn't even trying to cover the tight end. And he was in a zone. I don't get it. Ah. Okay. Let's go ahead and return middle. And back to return is going to be Joe Mixon at the goal line. So we'll just bring this up. And come on. All right, broke a tackle. Now get to the outside. Come on, break some more tackles, Joe. And down to 30 again. 28-yard gain. 4:50 to go in the game. And this play is okay. You know, this play might actually work now since he likes to overthrow people by 50 yards. First and 10. And right there. Over the middle. I shouldn't have lobbed it, but Neal comes up with the catch anyway. 19-yard gain. I feel like I missed Westbrook running wide open down the side. Feel like I did. I don't know why. I just have that gut feeling. but on first and 10 and shotgun, and we're going to run right up the middle with Samaje Perine. And there we go. Perine brushed through three people and gets the first down. Pretty sure I said brushed, but still, he gets the first. 9 carries, 73 yards, 3 touchdowns. Why not using Alex Ross? Because Mixon and Perine are doing enough. Perine's having an amazing day. Oh, for kick return, maybe. I didn't think about that, honestly. I'll have to go see what his stats are. I forgot about Ross. I forgot Alex Ross existed. But I'll have to look and see what his kick return stats are after this game. But second and 19 in shotgun. Shepard on the outside. And they are playing very far off Shepard. But we're still going to send him deep. They're not expecting it. And right there, we're going to heave it for Shepard. Except for he underthrows it. But Shepard comes back and makes it. Never mind. I thought he was going to make the catch. But yeah, I'll have to look and see what Alex Ross's stats are. 4 verticals. That'll work. Third and 19. And... Alright, see if we can get this first. And right there over the middle, there we go. Caught by Micaiah Quick, who... What? We have Quick playing? I didn't know Quick was playing. Okay. So that's up first and 10. And now we're on a read option. Now, question is, how well is this read option going to work? Perine's not even in the game right now. It's Mixon. I guess Perine got tired. But first and 10, go to the outside. And come on, Baker. There you go. Break a tackle. Run after a 4-yard game. I feel like I could have got more on that had I paid attention. Let's try another triple option because this is either going to result in a horrible, horrible decision by me. Or another touchdown for Samaje Perine, so. And nope, never mind. It's going to result in a play for Joe Mixon, where he breaks through 3 tackles and is finally brought down. I apparently need to up their tackling a little bit because they can't tackle anybody except these receivers. Try another read option. Oh my god. Can I just audible this to a straight run play? Because look at that. They have 3 linemen right there. Samaje is going to walk this in. Never mind, he's going to get hit, but he gets into the end zone. Touchdown, Oklahoma. So Samaje has 4 touchdowns in the first half. Hashtag shake and bake. Guess that works. Hashtag P Rhino right now. 4 touchdowns. And right down the middle. I need to throw it with Baker a little bit more, but Samaje's working so well. I don't understand it. And I just skipped right past that, but Oklahoma State was probably still losing to Mississippi State or whoever it was. Anyway, kickoff, up by 15, under 3 minutes going half. And next half, we might start chewing some clock because this game, I don't feel like it's going to be close, especially if we can get another touchdown. I mean, we need to stop them from scoring, and then if we get another touchdown, we'll start chewing some clock next half. Okay, so we're going to bring Evans right at the middle. And wait, who's blitz on the outside? I didn't even see who that was. We're bringing a corner? I didn't want to bring a corner. And Green made a hit, but can't bring him. I don't know who Green is. Let's go look at that right now. Who in the world is Green? Because that is bugging me. I've never heard his name. Like, even whenever Sanchez got injured, Green didn't replace him. Dakota Austin did. Cornerback. Marcus Green. He's a freshman redshirt. I mean, he's wearing Aaron Colvin's number. While we're here, let's look at... Let's look at some Alex Ross stats. See what he's got. 94 speed, 97 acceleration. Yeah, we're going to go ahead and make Ross our kick returner. And then who's got decent speed here? Who's the highest speed? Make Ross our punt returner as well. Trey, thanks for giving me that idea. Should help us. All right. So, 2:45 to go in half. And what are we gonna do here? Let's play some cover 2 spy. Play a lot of zone right now. If they go deep, we're gonna get burned. Oh my god, they're going right over the middle. And he's wide open. Okay. That was a risky play to call. That's probably a stupid play to call as well. But we'll just blitz this time. We'll just blitz and no we're not. Come on, get over there, please. Cover your guy. Yeah, he got there. Oh my god, I hate this game. I should have rubbed down the backfield. I hit the stick. That is something that happened to me so much in the other Dynasty, is that I would time that perfectly, get in the backfield, but I guess I get there too soon, and he doesn't go down. Second and seven, and oh, I went for the QB. All right, 6 yard gain. Third and one. If I can time that again and read it correctly, we're going to stop him. And I didn't read it correctly. Of course. 11-yard gain. And their drive stays alive. Crap. Cover one linebacker's five. Come on, Tapper. I believe in you. You haven't got back to the quarterback like at all today. Oh, there he hit him. And the ball flies out of bounds. Okay, so that quarterback started out pretty bad, but he's been decent since then. Like, he started out throwing two horrible passes, but has since gotten better. And now on second and 10, we're going to bring Evans. Oh, no. Oh, I was offsides. Crap. I tried to time it. Didn't work. And, all right, we hit him. I thought at first we were going to get a pick on that, and that was going to be really mad because I knew it was going to get called back. Ah, that's an offside on Evans, 5 yards. Wait, did they accept that? It would have been, what, third and one, had they not? I mean, I don't know. All right, whatever. Replay the down, I guess, second and five. And where are you going with that? That was a horrible decision. All right, cover one robber. That should work for me. Play some man coverage here. We're going to go ahead and bring Tapper. Let's see what Tapper can do. Come on. No. Get in before he gets the first. There you go, Hatari Bird. Fourth and inches. If they go for that, we're bringing everybody. It says they're kicking. They better not fake it. They better not fake it. I'll just be Ross, just in case. Oh, y'all going to chew down some clock? I'm fine with that. I am perfectly okay with you guys chewing down a little bit of the clock, because I'm just going to start chewing clock anyway. I'm checking Twitter results right now, or Twitter things right now. Hey, Brian Dawkins can be brought into the Hall of Fame next year. That's interesting. And Donovan McNabb, Jason Taylor, LaDainian Tomlinson, and Heinzler. Tomlinson's getting in. LT's getting in next year. Dawkins should get in, honestly. I'm biased on that because I'm an Eagles fan, but Dawkins should be a first ballot Hall of Famer. But back to return now is going to be Alex Ross, because Shrey gave us that idea. And we're going to see if we can get anything with Ross. You know, how did I... Okay. Yeah, I got nothing. That was my bad. I don't know how I forgot about Ross, because I had one game... Shepard hasn't caught a pass yet, but... I had one game in the Dynasty. I think it was like season one or two, where I had like three kickoff returns for touchdowns with Ross. I scored like 91 points that game or something. It was insane. And right there, wide open, is Jarvis Baxter. Don't step out of bounds. Thank you. What? I didn't mean to juke. I meant to I was getting ready to do a hesitation step and avoid that guy, but I accidentally juked out of bounds. So we stopped the clock at least, but that's not what I wanted to do at all. Okay, and now Mayfield's under center, so there's the snap, and come on, nope, roll out to the right side, there we go, throw on the run. Oh my god, what? Level him. That was stupid. That was really stupid. I thought I could float it over that guy. Apparently that linebacker had other ideas. And I have emails that I need to look at. But I'll get to them after this one. Anyway, bring in Jordan Evans. Under pressure, goes to the outside. And I tried to go for the pick. Didn't work. And yet nothing big. All right. Yeah, we're fine. Just pretty much the alerts of people following me on Twitch, which is nice. But first and 10, 42 seconds to go in the half. And we're going to bring Tapper. We're going to keep bringing Tapper because he's going to get back to him at one point today. I really wish we could force a turnover right now. We really need a turnover. Ohio State barely beat Buffalo. Like 27 to 20. It just showed up on the bottom of the screen. Ball State barely beat FCS. Arkansas beat, crap, I didn't even see who it was. Second and three, though. Go, all right, he chunks that out of bounds. Okay, we can hold him to another field goal. What happened to the stream? Did it screw up for you guys, too, or just me? Okay. Let me know if the stream just acted funny, because to me, it started buffering. Yeah, hey. Someone said, hey, night, so hey, what's going on? And, wow, I screwed that up. Oh, no. See, you distracted me, Die Trail. You distracted me. I'm blaming you on that. That's my excuse. It's not that I'm bad at this game. I'm blaming him. Blitz the safeties. This is probably another bad decision. Come on. Snap the ball. And, come on, get back there. Make the play. I used the hit stick. Why didn't you dive? Here is Garrett. Great. Okay, well, field goal block. Hey, is the stream like acting weird for you guys? Because to me, it looks super delayed, and now it's buffering again. I'm actually going to refresh the page, because I feel like it's screwing up for me only. If it's screwing up for you guys, let me know. Because this is like my first stream, so I really have no idea what I'm doing. They challenged the play, and the play stood anyway. So, field goal block. Okay, and kick right down the middle. But now 28-23. Alright, 20 seconds to go before the half. Should we just run down the clock? Like, I seriously feel like we should just run down the clock. Unless we could turn this for a touchdown. Come on, Ross. Never mind. Not going to get anything. Alright, it's fine for you. Okay, I feel like it just screwed up on my end. Like, it buffered on my end. So it was, like, super delayed. Like, it was showing, a minute delayment. Like, it needs to not do that, please. But first and 10, no. We're gonna try to score for halftime. I thought about it, but throw off my back foot. Not going to work. I'm being stupid with the ball right now. That's really going to come back and hurt us. I honestly probably should just run down the clock, but I don't want it to be a 5-point game with Tulsa going into halftime. And right there. Never mind. Gonna get sacked. Timeout. This is stupid right now. I hate this. Light a fire skill activated. Yeah, that'd be great. Light a fire under somebody. Someone get open here. We need a huge touchdown. Right there over the middle. That's Jarvis Baxter. Brought down. Come on, burn timeout. 3 seconds to go. We can heave it to the end zone from here. I believe. And I'm just going to go ahead and hide the video preview because it is acting really weird for me. If anything starts screwing up, you guys, let me know. Like, in the chat. I can still see that. I'm 90% sure. But right here, let's just see if Shepard or somebody can get open. And just heave that, Baker. Come on, catch it, somebody. Not you. Incomplete. Okay. 5-point game going to halftime. Oh, man, that sucks. And I'm going to need to text the Weave and say that I might be late getting on Skype tonight because I didn't expect the stream to go this late, honestly. I thought the stream would be over by 10, but at this rate, it's going to be over by maybe like 10:15, 10:20. I don't know yet. But kickoff, Ross back to return. And come on, there we go. We got some good blocks down the sideline. Come on, break a tackle, Ross. Down at the 40. I'm good with that. I am fine with that. And now on first and 10, we're just going to start running the ball because that's obviously working the best today, is giving it to Samaje and telling, never mind. I thought it was working best today. They made some adjustments. Maybe just one play, but still. I'll try a read option. May have to sub in Trevor. Not really. Not happening. Baker's a 94 overall. We're not subbing in Trevor Knight. And juke to the outside. Come on. No, come on. I'm used to Corey Cannon speed in this game already. Okay. We just need the first. I need to calm down. I need to calm down because if I don't, we're going to end up losing to Tulsa. and that is not the way I want to start this new series. Now he roll out to the right side and throw that on the run downfield. Caught by Samaje Perine. There we go. Truck through that guy. Okay, down inside the five. A 55-yard gain. Finally, we got something through the air. Granted, it was to the running back who's been killing them all game, but we finally got something through the air. And they are more than prepared for us to run it up the middle. So we're going to run a play action and then roll out to the right side and dump it off to the tight end. Touchdown. No. All right, yeah, he got into the end zone. Touchdown to Carson Meyer? I don't know. That's our first passing touchdown, though. So that's good. I am fine with that. Go ahead and kick this field goal and take our 12-point lead. And they, see how many people they had stacked on the line there? That was insane. I don't know if our fullback could have got through that. And now kick it right down the middle. I'm going to take a drink of water while this is going on, because I normally don't touch anything on kickoffs anyway. Okay. Should be good now. And is this their last five drives? Yeah. They've scored on each of their last five drives. I don't think I've made them punt once. That's kind of stupid on my part. But first and 10, and we're going to bring Tapper into the backfield. Come on. Somebody get back there. Oh my god, who was that? Was that Invanosaur that just knocked him out? And the Weave says that PJ Invanosaur sounds like a Pokemon. Invanosaur sounds like a Pokemon, which it kind of does, actually. But second and 5, and play action, and alright, right there over the middle. Come on. We gotta do something. We cannot stop their offense. I mean, I guess it's realistic. Sooners defense could not stop Tulsa's offense this past season. But this is annoying right now. First and 10. And screen to the outside. That's like the fourth time they've ran that, and it's never worked. It's resulted in 2 incomplete passes and 2 1-yard losses. So, I mean, it's not a good play. I don't know why they keep doing it. All right, and we're going to bring Evans up the middle on 2nd and 11. Come on, you can get back there. I believe in you. Come on, get back. Nah, he's not holding onto the ball long enough for us to hit him. We need to hit him a few times. We need to scare him. And now it's 2nd and 10. We're going to call man-to-man coverage again. All right, Tapper, come on. It's your job to get back there. You haven't got back there all but like once today. Truck through that guy. There you go. And I dive too early. And it's intercepted by Jordan Evans, so it doesn't matter. Finally, we stopped him on a drive. I hesitated there because I thought about pitching. I seriously thought about pitching that ball, but that would have been completely and totally stupid. That would not have been a good idea. Adjustments. Let's start chewing some clock. Because, you know, it's getting late. I've been streaming for a little bit. We've got a 12-point lead. We start chewing down some clock. We've been streaming for, like, mystery for almost 2 hours. But first and 10, handoff from Mayfield to Perine up the middle, trucks through one guy, and a 10-yard gain on the play. How many carries does he have now? 12 carries for 88 yards, 7.5 yards a carry, and 4 touchdowns. So Majay's had a pretty good day, don't you guys think? Second and inches, mixing in the backfield, and there we go. All right, this time we're just going to keep it with Mayfield, and okay, that's one thing I have a problem with this game, is like, whenever you're running that triple option, if they take the 2 running backs and your QB has to keep the ball, he stays in that motion like he's going to pitch it, so you can't really juke anybody. And it's just frustrating because, like, right there, I could have got so much more had I been able to juke. But first and 10, handoff up the middle to Samaje Perine, and he's over 100 yards and still going in, finally brought down inside the 10-yard line, a 21-yard gain. 13 carries, 109 yards, and 4 touchdowns. Had a pretty good day. Turn your in-game volume down a little, please. Okay, I will turn down a little bit more. Man, I can turn my mic up. It's not at 100. But we'll turn that down to... hold on. We'll put that at 50, but we'll turn this down a little bit. Hopefully that's better. That's the second time someone's asked that, so hopefully it's okay now. That might be a little bit too quiet, honestly. Here we go. Let me put it right there. How's that sound, you guys? Is that a little bit better, or is my voice too loud now? Anyway, touchdown Baker Mayfield. And now we're up 42 to what? 23? Yeah. Yeah. Let me know if that's good for game volume, if it needs to go down a little bit more or go up. Other than that, we should be fine. I think the stream's going pretty well so far. My first stream, I feel like it's gone actually pretty smooth. And besides, like, in-game volume, very good. All right, thank you. All right. I mean, it is my first stream, so if some stuff is a little bit off, you gotta kind of expect that. I mean, I didn't even know I could stream till very recently, because my internet's absolutely garbage. But I happened to stumble across someone that was, like, streaming Madden the other day, and, like, his quality was kind of off. I was like, I wonder why I stream at such low quality. So I started Googling if I could stream in lower quality, and apparently I could. So that brings us to here. But come on, bring him down. Okay, he's going to the outside. Stop him. All right. I've got to get better on defense, honestly, because it's kind of stupid right now that I don't think I forced him to punt once, and we still haven't faced anywhere near the toughest offense we're going to face in this series. Second and inches, and come up the middle. There we go. Get him down in the backfield. That's a loss of six. Who was that? Is that Walker? Charles Walker? I think. Not going to guarantee it. 97. I think that's Charles Walker. Anyway, third and six. And what are we going to do here? We're going to be tackled. Been doing that most of the game anyway. Nope, third and six. And Tapper's going to come get him. I'm going to force your way into the backfield. All right. Finally, we force a punt. At least they should finally punt it here. Right? Yes, finally. I think this is the first time. This could be the second time we forced them to punt. Either way, they've scored too many points for my liking in this game. With our starters in. Like, if our backups came in and they got to this point, be like, oh, okay. But it's been our starters the entire game. And, yeah, Ross going to make that guy miss. Come on. Ah, I ran to my own blocker. I probably could have got a little bit more. Okay. I think we're having a pretty realistic amount of plays. I mean, we've got, like, around 45 each. How many are in a game normally? 120, I think. So, I feel like this is going pretty good so far for a first stream. First and 10, and come on, pick up that block. There you go. Juke to the outside, and brought down after a 14-yard gain. I am running quite a bit with Baker. 13 carries, 49 yards. He might have more carries than Samaje right now. It's kind of a problem. I don't like running my QB that much. I like having a mobile quarterback for those situations, but running my QB that much can get kind of annoying, or at least risk injury. And that's no gain on the play. How many carries does he have? Are we going to show or not? 14 carries, okay. He's also got four touchdowns. He's had a pretty productive day. And I still don't think Shepard's even caught a pass, because I keep sending him deep, and like the couple times he's gotten open, it either gets picked or, like I said, either gets picked or he drops it, and right there we get picked off. I thought we could get that safety. I don't know when I'm ever going to learn in this game that those safeties are just ridiculous, and I'm never going to be able to beat them. But first and 10, under 2 minutes to go in the third quarter, and we're going to bring the blitz again. All right. That's a game, or a loss of two. Force another punt. I just want to kill their entire hopes and dreams right now. Because obviously, you know, this game is still within reach. What is it, like a 19-point game? This game's still within reach for them. We just don't want them to get that close. But those slant routes have been killing us all day. And we injured Kevin Lucas, who has 5 catches for 51 yards. I mean, it is a video game. So is it okay to be happy about an injury? I mean, in real life, that's horrible whenever you're happy about an injury. You should never be happy about an injury in real life, but we're in a video game, and he's kind of been destroying us all day. And, wow, we still, like, you're just man-on-man coverage. That is your job, Jordan Thomas, and you still let up a first down. We brought the house on him, and, yeah, we're going to need to call timeout or something. We're burning a timeout. We were in, like, a goal line set. And they had 5 wide out, so no, not running that. All right, let's go ahead and blitz again. But this time we're going to control Tapper. We're going to try to get this lineman out of Jordan Evans' way. And come on, game. Let me bring him down right there. 7-yard gain. That should have been a no game. But the game refused to let me bring him down, even though I was holding the right stick down and everything, or towards him. No, we're not going to blitz any corners. We're already getting burned enough in our secondary. We don't need to be blitzing corners. Okay, maybe we should have blitzed a corner. Maybe that would have been a decent idea. Okay. Dane Evans, you're going to need to stop doing what you're doing, because you are kind of embarrassing my defense right now. I mean, if Tulsa's offense does this to us, what is TCU's going to do? And for those of you who weren't here at the beginning of the stream, whenever we made our schedule, we have like Clemson and Ohio State and Notre Dame. And there are a few others on the schedule that are going to be pretty tough if our defense plays like crap. But on second 11, we're going to bring Jordan Evans. And that he dropped it. But that probably would have been another first down. Thomas, you're going to need to stop being garbage. Like now. Third and 11. 14 seconds to go in the game. I mean, not in the game, in the quarter. Bring Tapper on this and try to force another punt. There's not a minute field goal range. We don't want this to become a two-possession game. Tapper, come on, get back there. Okay, yeah, they're not getting the field goal range. You can't run the ball on third and 11 on us and expect to really gain anything. Okay, now can we try to... All right, no, we're not going to try to block it there. Now it's a three-possession game, and there's going to be 8 minutes to go in the game because we play eight-minute quarters. Are they going to go for it on this fourth down? That is the question. It looks like they are, because it's suggesting to me normal plays. So on fourth and 13, they're going to try to get this first. And I swear to God, defense, if you let up a first down, I'm going to scream. And they go to the outside, and okay, they screwed each other there, because I don't know who that was intended for, but one of them ripped it out of the other's hand. It looked like it was intended for 80, but 88, like, tipped it away or something. I don't know, but I'll take the ball. Bad play by them, and I'm fine with that. Okay, so there's under 8 minutes to go. We just have to chew down some clock. I don't know how much we're going to be able to chew down on this possession, but we're gonna try to chew off a pretty good chunk. And right there, Baker. Okay. Baker's still going. 13-yard gain. Finally brought down. First and 10 from the 46-yard line. And no, I just selected a deep ball, and I don't want to do that. I'm kind of mad that I haven't been able to go to Shepherd at all today. Hopefully I'll be able to involve him more, like, in later games, but... I mean, he just didn't get open, or whenever he did get open today, it was just a bad throw. Like, if you weren't here earlier, there was one where Shepherd was just streaking down the sideline. There was nobody within 10 yards of him, and Baker sails it 20 yards past his head. Dang. I'm going to see if we can get something here, but nope, not going to get anything. We're going to roll it to the right side, and I thought I could hit Deron Neal on the run there, but obviously not. I have not had a good day with Baker Mayfield. What did that show, like 10 of 22 and 3 interceptions or something like that? 4? I'm not even sure. I mean, if you guys have watched my other football series, you guys know I throw a ton of interceptions. But I win most of the time, so it's okay. And brought in after an 8-yard gain, sets up 3rd and 2. So Majay, he's had a pretty good day. 3 catches for 77 yards. He also has like 4 rushing touchdowns. I mean, he's done pretty well for himself today. And now we're going to run another triple option and see if we can get anything. Come on. All right, good. Good. There we go. Yeah, just pitch back to Samaje, and he gets the first down. 8-yard gain on the play. I tried to time that to the very last second to see if Samaje could get to the outside and get a touchdown. But, you know, I'll chew off another 30 seconds. Not a problem to me. I mean, if we get a touchdown here, this game is over. I mean, I don't know how many of you guys were actually expecting me to lose to Tulsa, because it doesn't look like we're going to. So I think this game was pretty much a guaranteed win almost. But they played better than I thought they would. This offense is decent. 17 carries, 137 yards, and 4 touchdowns. He's averaged like 8 yards a carry. Let's run this halfback off tackle, because that should be Mixon. And it's not going to be Mixon because P. Ryan came off. So now Mixon's back there, and this is going to be Daniel Brooks getting his first carry of the day, and brought down for a 3-yard loss by Patera Wilson. It's got to be Tara, right? The P has to be silent, like in pterodactyl. I don't know. I've never heard that guy's name. 3rd and 4. Shotgun, 4.5 minutes to go. We're not in shotgun. We're in pistol. Whatever. Anyway, there's a snap. Roll out to the right side. And come on, break away from your coverage, please. Break away from your coverage, please. Whatever, just take the sack so we can continue to chew clock. That's all I care about right now. We'll just come out, kick the field goal, make it a 22-point game, and give them the ball back. As long as I can make this. I didn't miss a field goal earlier. That's been the only one I've attempted so far. And there's the kick, and it is good. Okay. So that makes it 45-23. Studio update. Notre Dame lost to Temple. So there goes their 11th ranking. Awesome, guys. I scheduled you guys because I thought you would be pretty highly ranked. And then you lose to an unranked team. I mean, Temple in real life this year was pretty good. Weren't they like at 1.9-0? I think. So, I mean, they were pretty good this year, but really wish Notre Dame had kept on winning. So they could be like in top 10 whenever we played them, because they still have a chance to get back up into the rankings. Because we don't play them until like week, I don't think I put them on schedule like week 11 or something. Okay, there's the snap, and goes to the outside. Come on, Striker. Striker! I tried to strip the ball. That was stupid. I should have just went for the tackle. Whatever, tripped him up at the 50. And sorry, I'm, like, taking breaks. I'm trying to check messages. And sorry. All right, we're good now. Let's get back into the game. 1st and 10. There's snap. Evans goes to the outside. Caught by... No, come on, Romar, get him. Oh, my God, that was stupid by me. Come on, get him. Don't let him score that big of a play. 40-yard gain. That was stupid of me. 1st and goal. Double safety blitz. This should be fun. Come on, Ahmad Thomas. You can get back there. I believe in you. I ran this play a few times today. Didn't. Oh, no. Come on. Oh, my God. No, he was out of bounds. There's no way he stayed in bounds on that. There is no way. No, they've got to challenge that, because I don't think he was in bounds. There we go. Let's look at this booth review real quick. There's no way he stayed in bounds for this. There's the ball. Ah, dang it! It looks like his right foot was still in the end zone. No, come on. That's a little too close to call. I don't know what they're gonna say. Play stands. Oh, that was a good catch. That was a very good catch. Okay, we're just gonna bring Devontae Bond. This dude's uncovered right here. Yep, I tried to go and cover him, but it didn't work out too well. So it's a 14-point game with 3 minutes to go. We're about to get the ball back. I'm assuming they're gonna go for an onside, and that's exactly what they do. They still have all 3 timeouts, so they could potentially get the ball back again. But I'm going to look to just run down a little bit more of the clock, because I'm seriously thinking we could maybe end the game this drive. I mean, if we score again, I think it's definitely over. Because that would be a 20-point deficit with 3 minutes to go in the game. And out to Piran up the middle, and he's got the first down immediately. That's not how you chew clock, Samaje. 12-yard game. That is not how you chew any clock, Samaje. Hey, Shrey, you're back. Did you have to go eat or something? I'm not really sure. I know she didn't comment for a while. But, yeah, as you can tell, we're kind of dominating them right now. And Samaje, 7-yard game. Okay, he has 19 carries for 156 yards. Shrey, you haven't really missed much. They've gotten a few good plays in on offense. And I don't think... Really, you missed anything on offense, really. And Samaje's breaking tackles. First down on the play. And right now we're just chewing clock. That's about it. Okay, and there is no two-minute warning in this game, so... I mean, there is no two-minute warning in college football. But they're burning timeouts now. We've been in the red zone six times, have five touchdowns and a field goal. We'll hand off to Samaje up the middle. And he's brought down after about an eight-yard gain. What were the scoring drives? I mean, I can look at that after. I don't think I can look at it right now, can I? I mean, I did throw a touchdown pass with Baker, but I've also thrown a couple more picks. It hasn't been good. Scoring summary. Yeah, we can look at that real quick. So we had, like, Samaje's, like, third touchdown here, or fourth touchdown. And then Kyaris Garrett got one right there at the end of the half. And there's the touchdown pass with Baker. I think I can actually view the replay. And it's just like a play action, rolled out to the right side and threw on the run into the end zone. And then after that, Baker ran in for a touchdown, and Cyber got a field goal, and then they got a touchdown recently. Oh, Counter-Strike. I didn't know I had any Counter-Strike fans. I tried to play Counter-Strike, and I just got blown back and decided I didn't need to play that game. Really decided I did not need to play that game because it was... Wait, Jarvis Baxter wasn't running back just now, but he got the first. But Red Bulls 20, you said you were checking Counter-Strike streams. I tried to play Counter-Strike and just got demolished. It was not fun. I mean, it was fun, but I just never got better. I played it for like 2 weeks and never got any better. And just ended up rage quitting it. But first and goal, just chewing some clock. Breaking tackle. I don't know. Don't run into the end zone. Let's run down a little bit more clock. I think we just pretty much run down the rest of this. Can I just kneel it? Please? Kneeling on the goal line, or should we just strong toss and get Samaje a fifth touchdown? Run a QB sneak? Nah. I'll just toss it. We'll just toss it and get Samaje his fifth touchdown of the day. And run along the sideline. Or goal line. And touchdown Samaje P. Ryan. Cross 50 points. Yeah, cutting back with Baker was probably a jerk move. But I thought I could just run down the clock. But, you know, thinking about it now, kneeing on the 1 yard line is stupid. It sucked whenever Texas did that against us earlier this season in real life. Also, QB sneaks in this game like hardly work. That's why in my Oklahoma Dynasty, anytime it was a situation where I could have ran a QB sneak, I gave it to my fullback. In Madden, they work, but in this game, they do not work hardly at all. At least to me. I've seen a few people be able to pull them off, but I really can't. So I give it to my fullback normally in those situations. Right there, I just want to get Samaje's fifth touchdown of the day. Get Samaje on the Heisman watch list. And is it right to run double safety blitz right now? I know they're just going to be airing it out. I want to see if I can sack him at least one more time today. We've never been able to hit him like at all today. There we go. Ahmad Thomas gets the sack on the play. So Thomas picks him off and sacks him. I think that's actually Thomas's second sack. Oh no, CS. Counter-Strike, like, my graphics card is fine for it, but I wasn't good at the game, and it was confusing, and I tried to use my controller. Turns out I could not play FPS with, keyboard, just terrible with it. I got to be decent at Call of Duty, like, whenever I used to play that, but holy crap, like, Ahmad Thomas, you're going crazy today, and trying to injure people. But yeah, I tried to play CS:GO. It just didn't work. I wasn't good at the keyboard. Being a first-person shooter, but like whenever I was in high school, I was decent at Call of Duty. But that was about it. They don't play a whole lot of FPS. But Ross to the outside. Can I get a? Oh my god! If I can get a kickoff return for a touchdown today, keep going, Ross. Okay. But if I get the opportunity, I'm running that back. I think in six seasons of the Oklahoma Dynasty, I returned one punt for a touchdown. Where's you gonna knee it? Do I have a Wii U? No, I do not. I do not have a Wii U. I would like to get one, but right now the next expensive thing on my list is a 3DS capture card. And those things are expensive. They're like $250 to $300. And that will be the end of this game, 52-31. We're still going to advance the next week to see who we are playing and stuff like that, because I honestly don't remember who we're playing week two. We'll check recruiting and stuff like that. We still have a little bit to do in this stream, but this is probably the only game. Yeah, this is something that I whipped. Shepard didn't get anything. Waiting on a mouse pad as of now. Oh. I mean, those aren't too bad. Play the game, Samaje Perine, 22 carries, 173 yards, and 5 touchdowns. I mean, he did pretty good. He did pretty good today. But in case you weren't here for the entire game, the pretty much highlight of this game was Samaje Perine. As you saw his stats, 5 touchdowns. It's kind of ridiculous. And Sterling Shepard didn't do anything. I could not get Shepard the ball all day. Like, even whenever he was open, Baker was overthrowing him. Like, early in the game, there was one where Shepard was like, he had like 10 yards of separation on his defender. The safety didn't even realize where Shepard was. And he would have easily had a touchdown, and Baker chunked it over his head by about 20 yards. And getting the thumbnail shot for YouTube, so I just had to take a break there for a second. But yeah, that, in case you're ever wondering, this is where I normally get the thumbnail shots, is the post-game pictures. The Wii U is great with amazing Mario games like Mario Kart 8 and Mario 3D World. The only, like, I don't have a Wii U, but I've been watching some of the Mario Maker stuff, and that game actually looks really fun. I should have looked at game stats. I apologize. But the Mario Maker game looks really fun. I think, who's the main guy I've been watching with it? Uber Hexer Nova, and he's been playing a lot of like the difficult maps, and that game looks ridiculously fun. I just wish I had a Wii U. But anyway, around the country, Bama barely beat Virginia Tech. Tennessee shuts out FCS East. Marshall beats Miami of Ohio, and Missouri beats FCS East. Wait, what? Mizzou and Tennessee both played FCS East. That's interesting. Well, let's go in advance, and we will advance to the next week. See if we move in the rankings at all. And see how the rest of that goes. Were there any other things that were announced at the award show? Who won Rookie of the Year? Like, in the NFL. Does anyone know? Was it Gurley? I'm almost positive it would be Gurley, right? Todd Gurley? Let's advance to week 2 at Clemson. Oh, God. That game's going to be terrifying. Kind of scared to play at Clemson. I don't know when that game is going to be. I don't know when the next stream is going to be. Most of my streams will probably be on the weekends, mainly because, one, I don't want it to interfere with my regular channel recording time, and also I don't want to stream, like, because I'm home most of the day, but I feel like most of you guys are in school, right? So, like, streaming on a Tuesday at noon wouldn't be a good idea, because I feel like most of you guys are still in school then, right? That makes... Because I think so. But let's see if we move up in the rankings at all. Hopefully we do. That'd be nice. Shrey, I'm guessing you're saying yeah to Todd Gurley was the one that won the Rookie of the Year. Did they not comeback player of the year? That's got to be Eric Berry. And our fullback committed to Texas. What? Okay. Well, I guess we really don't need a fullback. That's nice. He went after 1 week. That's garbage. Ha. Water tastes good whenever you've been talking. Yeah, see, I'm assuming most of my subscribers are still in, like, middle school, high school, stuff like that. So, I normally won't stream at times I feel like would be a bad idea for that. Anyway, we move up to 18. Clemson is now number 11. I guess we both moved up after Notre Dame's loss. They're picking Clemson to win. Oh, Shrey, you're off Friday? That's weird. Well, next Friday, my little brother's out of school as well, so I won't be able to stream then. It'll probably be next Saturday before I get to stream again. But we'll check Heisman Watch. Samaje's got to be on the list, right? Yeah, Samaje moved into the list. That's what I'm talking about. 5 touchdowns will definitely do that. 22 carries, 173 yards, 5 touchdowns, 3 catches for 77 yards. Samaje balled out. Let's look at the rest of the top 25. Because we are getting close to wrapping up this stream. It's been 2 hours, so it's been pretty fun. Anyway, Ohio State stayed at number one. TCU beat LSU 31-29. And now my dog's barking outside, so she's going to need to shut up. Baylor won. Oregon won. Michigan State. Auburn. Who is the lowest to lose? LSU for the highest to lose. Dude, no. Oh, okay. I thought Notre Dame dropped out of the rankings. Did Temple even move into the rankings? I didn't see him. No, I don't think Temple... Did they get votes? They did get some votes. Boise State dropped out. I mean, it's no problem. Like, Shrey said, thank you for the stream. It's been fun, honestly. I mean, I figured it would be, but it's been... See, this is what I mean whenever I was talking about earlier, that the CPU will do some recruiting for you. Like, I left a lot of points available for the CPU to mess around with, so they did a little bit. But how was our... What? How are we losing that linebacker? What the heck happened? Were we fifth on his list a week ago? Come on, don't do this. You want to become a Sooner, I promise. How do they get 265? Okay, so right there along the left side, wherever you see the logos, I guess it's technically in the middle. Under top schools, by the logos, you can see how much bonus points they get. How does Oklahoma State get more than us? Proximity to home, athletic facilities, conference prestige. We've got to be higher than Oklahoma State in every single one of those. Unless Oklahoma State gets a little bit more due to proximity to home because they're closer to Missouri. Okay, well, whatever. We're still on his list, so we're fine there. But the one I'm seriously worried about is athlete. Where is he at? Michael Jackson. Oh, I forgot to put scouting points on him. No. Crap, we're going to lose him. But anyway, we'll throw something Michael Jackson. But Serge Jennings is the one I really want. This is the quarterback with 93 speed and 85 throw power and 82 accuracy. I think he's going to be all right. We did not have archery at my school. My school had like the standard sports, you know, soccer, basketball, baseball, football. We were good in like three of them, but sucked in football the entire time I was there. And then like this year we made the playoffs, so we did something right this year. We still want to try to get Ryan Hall, so let's throw a few more points into him. Darius White. See the other guy that can play quarterback? Yeah, wait. Did we get that dude who had, like, a ridiculous amount of speed? This guy. Andrew Clay. We'll just throw the remaining points on him. And then the CPU should be able to, you know, divvy up, you know, the rest of what they want. Ah. I mean, this stream has been a ton of fun, honestly. I about just dropped my phone. That would have been horrible. Because it probably would have cracked. But I think that's everything that we can check out here. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the stream. I mean, we went for like 2 hours. This should be up on YouTube here in the next couple days. So if you missed anything, you go back and watch that. What day is it going to be on YouTube? I have no idea. Because it's going to depend on how long it takes a 2-hour video to render and upload on really bad internet. But anyway, hopefully you guys enjoyed this. And I will talk to you guys next time.